kick us off?
Yeah, start with the team news, please, for the weekend. Due back.
About the team news, well, we have an injury for this week, just two players, Yarmolenko and Andy Carroll. All the other players are fit.
So, Lanzini, Kressel, Nasri, all fit again?
Yes, all of them are ready.
Anything likely to come in?
Who?
Are any of those three likely to play?
We'll see. Tomorrow we will decide the starting 11 and the players that go to the bench. But for the first week of the season, maybe we have different options to have the to make the starter, and also for players that must go to the bench.
And Pablo Zabaleta re-signed for another year. Announced yesterday. How pleased are you to have him?
Well, very pleased, because I think that Pablo is a very important player for our team, for the club, not only for the team, for the club. In his professional conduct, in his performance, and he's a leader inside the dressing room, and also I think he's a player that most part of the young players must see in the way he plays.
How much longer do you think he can go on playing, and do you think he can stay here another season beyond this one in England, or how do you see his future?
Well, it depends, of course, of next season, but Pablo is 100% fit. He works every day very, very hard, so I think that he can play another season without any problem.
Has he been a big influence for you?
Well, I knew Paolo from Manchester City, and before that from San Lorenzo in Argentina. I know what you can demand him, what you can receive for him, and I think that, as I just said, is a very important player.
And Sami Nasri, any update on whether he may be here again next season?
No, I repeat, I'm not talking about one name that I will not talk about next season till we finish this one.
How impressed have you been with him though this season? Had his injury problems? Have you seen enough of him, do you feel?
Well, when Sami arrived here, we knew that he was coming for a long time without playing, without working, so maybe it was one of the risks that we take when he signed here.
Do you know if he wants to stay?
I suppose, I repeat, I don't know. I not want to talk about that, because after that you change, or not you, but the media change the world.
And just on Pedro Obiang, the reports that he may leave in the summer.
Same answer of Sami Nasri.
Have you started looking to next season yet? Have you started planning at all? Spoke with the owners?
I always planning with the sport director, Mario Sillos, but finally we are not going to do nothing before we finish this season.
How much strengthening do you feel you need to make?
Well, we'll see. It depends of a lot of different things that we must analyse.
And just in terms of kind of keeping the core of the squad, the likes of Diop, Anderson and Rice, you'll be obviously very keen to do that moving forward, build on the foundations that you've laid this season?
Well, I think there were three players that we brought at the beginning of this season. Very good players, young players, so they are part of the squad that we want to build here.
You will be keen to keep them there, obviously, that would be important to you.
The same thing as players that go, as players that come, that player you can sell, that player, well, you cannot talk now.
Two games remaining then, you could finish eighth. How do you assess the season as a whole? Has it been a successful season for you?
For me, it has been a quiet season, if you compare, especially with the last season of this club. Of course, it was very different, because 8 or 9 games before we finished, we were out of relegation zone. After that, if we win the next two games that we must play, of course, can be better if we don't win it. But I think that all of us must demand more of ourselves and try to continue improving in this club. Maybe for this season it's okay. I'm not worried about what we did. There came a lot of new players. We have too many injured players. We were always fighting around the mid-top of the table. So I think it's not a bad season, but next I hope that we can improve it.
With the top six so competitive, what's realistic for this club, do you feel?
The reality of this club is that you have 60,000 people behind you, so it's a club that's a very big club with a big stadium, which maybe you cannot compete in money about another class, but there are another way to try to reduce the distance, And without putting before any target, I think we must try to always to fight for to be at the highest of the table as we can.
Can I just ask you about Lionel Messi? A lot of talk about him today after his performance last night. What did you make of it? And is he the greatest player of his generation, or even ever?
Well, I don't think it's fair to compare one generation with another one, with Pelé, with Maradona, with Johan Cruyff. I think that everyone has, in his moment, was the best player of the world. But I think in this case, Messi and Cristiano had fighting for a lot of years continue, not only one or two players that demand so much of themselves that they are not happy because they won white title. They want to continue. And Messi and Cristiano, both of them, are demonstrating what they can do for football and how important can be both of them for themselves to compete with another one. Messi demonstrated yesterday night that he decided the games alone. He has a very good team, but not playing may be the best game that he played, but he had three decisive actions that finished the game. One goal of free kick, one goal in an open play, and the last pass that they put for the fourth goal. So you can understand how important is he in every game.
And finally for me, there was a request to move the kickoff time for the weekend game because of the women's final. That was rejected by the FA, I think. Have you got any thoughts on that? What's your reaction?
No, I think that the best for our fans is to can go to both games. Maybe, I don't know the reason, that why I don't criticize or I'm going to talk too much about that. But of course, for our club, the best thing to have option for the fans to go to both games.
And I hope they don't leave at half-time against them to go watch the women, or I suppose is that inevitable?
I don't know, Wolfram.
Thank you.
Thanks, bye.
Hi Manuel, 1-0 win over Tottenham, maybe a lot of people wouldn't have expected that the other day. How much confidence does that give you going into Southampton this weekend?
Well, I don't know which were those people. We were absolutely sure that we can do it. And we went there and we did it. That's so important. I said 2 weeks before, and maybe as a manager it's difficult to start again with the third week, saying the same thing. Well, we played very well, but we couldn't win. I think that we deserve better results against Manchester United, against Leicester here at home. Finally, we continue playing the same way against Tottenham in their own stadium, and we beat them. So that gives us or affirm our trust what we were doing before when we couldn't have the results.
I know you don't want to talk about next season, but is that something that you would like to change? The good performances, turning them into results, what is it that you need to do that?
Yes, of course, there's a lot of things that we must do. We are going to analyse this season when we finish the season, but of course, as I just said, we need to improve. And if we want to improve, every area of the club must try to do it better.
Psychologically though, how important would it be to finish in the top 10?
Important for me, as high as you can finish at the end of the table, it will be better of the club, because it's if you compare with the last season, you improve. As much you improve in one season, of course it will be better. Also, I think it's for the fans, for the club, for the staff, for the players, it's good to finish winning our last game here at home against Southampton. We played a very good game here. If you compare also with the so problematic stadium that was our home stadium in the last season, I think that will be a good way to finish this season winning the last game here.
Just a couple more questions on Pablo Zabaleta, if that's okay. He's already acting as a mentor to some of the young players. Can you perhaps see him getting into coaching in the future?
Probably. I think that he has all the conditions to do it. He likes football. He's always demanding maximum from himself and from his mates. He has the characteristic of a leader, so one of the things that you need to be a manager or to be or continue involved in football, working with players, is the characteristic of the personality of Paul.
How much do you think a player like Ryan Fredericks can learn and develop under Pablo's
guidance? I think that not only Ryan Fredericks, because he plays in his same position, I think the way that Pablo managed himself in this profession, it's an example for all the other young players that are coming from our academy or players that are just arriving to the first team, as Nyangana, Holland, Coventry, Johnson, so the Frederick. There's a lot of young players that they follow in the way Paulo works in this profession, and they have more options to be successful.
I know there's still two games of the season left, but I just wanted to ask you how your first season back in the Premier League has been, whether you've enjoyed yourself being back in the Premier League.
Yes, I enjoy, because I came to a big club after that, because the Premier League, I said before and I repeat it now, is the best league in the world. So to return here, I'm happy. For the other side, well, I also want to do it better. Maybe it's my first time in Europe that I don't qualify for the same one in Malaga that I took the club at the middle of the season, that I don't qualify for the Euro competition. So I hope that next season we are going to improve.
Felipe Anderson scored twice in the 2-1 win over Southampton in December. I think at that time he scored 7 in his last 9 appearances and was on fantastic form. How do you rate his season, his first in the league?
For Felipe, I think that was a very good sign for our club, a young player that makes a difference in a lot of games. I think that we evaluate him. For me, it's the same evaluation I have from the team. It was a good season, but I think that Felipe will improve a lot after that. After playing 1 year here and after knowing what is the Premier League, I am sure that next season we will see another Felipe Anderson. Better, he did it well this season, but he will do it better next one.
Just finally, talking about first seasons again, your opposite number, Ralph Hasenhüttl, in the dugout at the weekend. How have you...
So, sorry, who?
Ralph Hasenhüttl.
Southampton manager.
How do you think he's adapted to the Premier League, obviously keeping Southampton?
Really, I don't know too much about him. We started, I think, one of the first games that he was in charge when we played against him. He was in a very difficult position. The team was in relegation position. I think that he saved 2 or 3 games before, so I hope that I'm sure that he has done a very good work.
Thanks, Mama.
Thank you. Cameras off.